Welcome students to Chemistry Concept. This is Pankaj Singh and let's discuss Williamson synthesis, or more accurately Williamson's ether synthesis. This is a method to prepare ethers, and in this we start with sodium alkoxide. Now this sodium alkoxide is prepared by a reaction of sodium metal with alcohols. And when we reacted with another alkyl halide, okay, again in dry ether, we get RCH2OR- NaX. This NaX is removed, and this is how we get an ether. For example, if I react CH3CH2ONa, that is sodium ethoxide with CH3Cl, that is chloromethane, it results into formation of CH3CH2OCH3, that is methoxyethane. Okay, and obviously it is a substitution reaction. Now there are few limitations, and what are those? Let's say if I want to prepare CH3 O CH3, that is methyl isobutyl alcohol. In this case, there are two options. Either I can start with CH3O Na and reacted with CH3Cl to get this product. This Na and this Cl will come out and I'll get the product. Someone may say that there is one more option, and that is I start with CH3ONa, that is I start with primary, in the first case I have used primary alkyl halide and tertiary sodium alkoxide. But someone may say we do it other way around. That means we start with primary alkoxide and we use tertiary CH3C alkyl halide. Then also we'll be getting the same product. That means chlorine would be released from here, sodium will be released from here, and I'll be getting the same product. Logically it looks, yes, it is possible, we'll be getting the same product. But the answer is no. And this is the exception of, or we can say limitation of, Williamson's ether synthesis. That in this method we can never use a tertiary alkyl halide. We'll be using if we have to make something tertiary, we'll be using tertiary alkoxide. And the answer is because this tertiary alkyl halide will undergo elimination rather than substitution, because tertiary alkyl halides are highly reactive for the elimination reaction, and this is a base, So beta elimination will take place, and what will happen? That a chlorine would be released from here and a hydrogen from here. Okay, and we will be getting CH3 double bond CH2 plus HCl. We'll get an alkene. If in Williamson synthesis we start with a tertiary alkyl halide, we'll get an alkene. So in this method, we can never use a tertiary alkyl halide. If there's an option, we'll be using a tertiary alkoxide and not alkyl halide. I hope the thing was clear to you. Stay tuned for more videos of organic, inorganic and physical chemistry. And don't forget to subscribe, and I love if you give your feedback in our comment section. Thank you.